Now I invite His Excellency Mr. Jan Anthony Bruijsen, President of the Senate, Netherlands, for his keynote address.
Your Excellencies, dear colleagues, it is a great honor to be here today and to speak to you about this important topic, transformation in people's lives through public digital platforms. But first, it is a great privilege for the Dutch Parliament and for me personally to participate in this meeting. We are grateful to the Indian presidency of the G20 for the invitation to our country. More specifically, I would like to thank my colleagues from the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha and the President of the Interparliamentary Union, Mr. Duarte Pacheco, to allow us to join you here today. I believe that our parliaments can and should deliver valuable input to the G20 deliberations. Dear colleagues, because of the 175th anniversary of the constitutional reforms, the Dutch Senate has organized an exposition over the past weeks of our handwritten constitution of 1848. To see a document that has played such a pivotal role in our history, with the signatures of King William II and all the ministers of 1848, is a truly impressive experience. Imagine handwritten documents that still form the basis of many democracies present here today. Technology has come a long way, and during this session, we focus on the impact of public digital platforms on people's lives. Since 2010, India has built an impressive collection of public-facing digital platforms that have transformed its citizens' lives. And as I understand, it is the aim of India's government to expand and export this so-called DPI, Digital Public Infrastructure. During the G20 in June, the New Delhi Declaration was adopted. It draws attention to building safety, security, resilience, and trust in the digital economy. In 2023, digital public infrastructure has also been selected as one of this year's high impact initiatives to accelerate the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. With the introduction of the digital public infrastructure, we have seen the remarkable difference that digital services can make to people's lives through access to payments, finance, healthcare, education, and more. There are many advantages as these services are easily accessible once you have the right means, both financially, technically, plus you have to be tech savvy. The danger with these advantages is that at the same time, they also work as a disadvantage. When you have no access to these public digital platforms, you are left out and face the risk of falling behind. In the Netherlands, this is, for instance, the case for the elderly, low literate people, and people under or just on the minimum wage. Therefore, it is important that these groups also have easy and open access, and that both private and public digital services provide assistance when needed. This is exactly where parliaments can play a role. I believe that as members of parliament, it is our duty, as representatives of the people, that we question these issues, and that both digital affairs are at the center of our focus, both nationally and internationally. We need to question our ministers of digital affairs, but also the other ministers, that new initiatives and new laws benefit all citizens, not just those fortunate enough, but also those who do not have the same starting position. In the Dutch House of Representatives, the Committee of Digital Affairs was established in 2021. The committee focuses specifically on new technologies such as artificial intelligence, algorithms, and big data, and their influence on, for example, employment, safety, democracy, and privacy, but also on relationships between citizens and the government. The committee ensures connection in the handling of digital files in the various policy areas. 6 themes have been determined, on which she also plans committee debates. The Committee on Digital Affairs acts as a monitoring committee on various topics so that the expertise of its members is used in the treatment of legislative proposals. The Dutch Senate has for the past 2 years discussed the growing influence of AI on decision-making processes and the role of the Senate. This has resulted in a debate with the Minister of Digital Affairs. One of the conclusions of the debate was that the Senate would like to have more specialized expertise on AI within the support staff. Also, the Council of Europe is drafting a treaty on artificial intelligence with input from national parliaments after the Parliamentary Assembly of the Council of Europe called on the Committee of Ministers to elaborate a legally binding instrument governing AI based on a comprehensive approach. Coming back to our original topic, digital public platforms. With all these issues, it is important to have enough democratic control, especially where artificial intelligence and coding are concerned. I would like to know what your parliaments are doing to secure this democratic control. Your Excellencies, dear colleagues, thank you for your attention. It is a great privilege for us to be here today, and I look forward to the remainder of our discussions. Thank you very much.
Thank you, His Excellency.